I fail to understand why members of this committee or the American people should find any testimony that you give today to be truthful.
If I can respond to that.
It wasn't a question. On February 8th, 1982, you testified before the Senate Foreign Relations Committee about U.S. policy in El Salvador. In that hearing, you dismissed as communist propaganda report about the massacre of El Mozote, in which more than 800 civilians, including children as young as 2 years old, were brutally murdered by U.S.-trained troops.
During the 1980s, the Reagan administration's policy was that the United States needed to support pro-U.S. governments in Latin America against Soviet influence.
The Soviets today could recognize the Caribbean and Central America as vital to our interest. Shouldn't we also?
Consequently, the massive human rights abuses of these governments were to be downplayed, if not ignored, because the threat of a communist takeover was worse. Congress became very concerned about these abuses, and so started conditioning the aid on these regimes improving their behavior. Part of Abrams' job was to keep the money flowing to these governments, and he did that by downplaying or dismissing reports of abuses.
We don't know what the shouting is all about. It seems clear that we need to protect our own security interests this way.
Abrams' denial of the 1981 El Mozote massacre, where U.S.-trained El Salvadoran troops murdered more than 800 civilians, including children as young as 2 years old, was one of the most egregious examples. At the time, Abrams cast doubt on the reports of the massacre, which was by then well documented, saying that it appears to be an incident which is at least being significantly misused at the very best by the guerrillas. Abrams later pleaded guilty to two misdemeanor counts of withholding information from Congress about the Reagan administration's secret efforts to aid Nicaraguan Contra guerrillas with money they'd gotten from selling arms to Iran, known as the Iran-Contra affair. He was then pardoned, along with a number of other Iran-Contra conspirators, by President George H.W. Bush as part of a successful effort to obstruct the investigation of independent counsel Lawrence Walsh.
President Bush's pardon of Iran-Contra defendants undermines the principle that no man is above the law.
Abrams was then brought back into government by President Bush's son, President George W. Bush, because accountability is a thing that doesn't exist in Washington. That is, until Abrams had to face Congresswoman Ilhan Omar.